There is an undercurrent of racism and intolerance in the debate about immigration. We can argue over how prominent it is, how much of a factor racism is, but it's there. It's real. And journalists can't pretend like it's not there. The newest example is coming from Mike Huckabee. He tweeted this on Saturday. It has caused, obviously, a lot of controversy because it is a racist comment, saying that Nancy Pelosi loves MS-13, all that shameful rhetoric we've heard from others as well. And of course, this is something that has animated President Trump, first his campaign and now his presidency. He's been using harsher and harsher language to describe immigrants. This was a new low earlier in the week, using the word infest for the first time to describe people. He says illegal immigrants would be infesting the country. Now, again, like I said, it's the first time he's ever used that word to connotate people. Another example of how his rhetoric has been ramped up and up. And that message has been echoed by his media allies. We'll talk about that in a moment. But first, let me bring in a guest who's thought a lot about the effects of this kind of rhetoric and what it means. George Takei is an actor and activist who experienced Japanese internment camps firsthand as a child. George, thanks for being here.
Good to be here. If I make, I might make one correction. They were not Japanese internment camps. They were American internment camps for American citizens of Japanese ancestry here in the United States. Japanese internment camps were run by the government of Japan. Let me make that point.
I'm glad you did. And, you know, I wanted to talk to you about this because of the images this week that you wrote about for Foreign Policy magazine. Do you feel like history is repeating right now?
It is repeating itself, but it has gone to a new low with Donald Trump. When we were incarcerated, our families were intact. My parents were with me. But in this case, it's come to a chilling low where babies are torn away from their mothers and placed in separate internment camps. Now that Donald Trump has rescinded his zero tolerance policy, the children are being scattered throughout the country, making it even more complicated to reunite the families. So this is a new low in American history.
I'm concerned that some of the comparisons on television to internment camps, some of the references to Nazi Germany, are so seriously offending a part of the country that they can't hear the conversation, that they won't hear the conversation, and that some of these comparisons are so inflammatory that they're actually hurting your cause. How do you respond to that?
No. The inflammatory rhetoric is lies, and that's a similarity between our incarceration and what's happening today. We were characterized, by the government, classified as enemy aliens. We were neither. Right after Pearl Harbor, young Japanese Americans rushed to their recruitment centers to volunteer to serve in the U.S. military. They were denied military service and categorized as enemy aliens, which we neither of which we were. Those young patriots were volunteering to fight for America, possibly even die for America. And to call them the enemy was nonsensical. And equally crazy was calling us aliens. My grandparents were the ones that immigrated to this country. My mother was born in Sacramento. My father was a San Franciscan. They met and married here in Los Angeles. My brother and sister and I were born here. We're Americans. And to call us enemy aliens is absolutely a lie, but repeated often enough and it becomes a reality. We had no less an authority than the Attorney General of the state of California, a man named Earl Warren, who I think most people will recognize as the man who went on to become the very liberal Supreme Court Chief Justice. He had his eyes, he was the Attorney General of the state of California, he had his eyes on the governor's office, and he saw that the single most popular issue in California at that time was the lock up the Japanese issue. And so this Attorney General of the state of California got on in front of that issue and made an amazing statement. He said, we have no reports of sabotage or spying or fifth column activities by Japanese Americans, and that is ominous because the Japanese are inscrutable. We can't tell what they're thinking, so it would be prudent to lock them up before they do anything. A big lie, taking that stereotype and grotesquely turning it against us. And that same thing is happening. The big lie is happening with Donald Trump now as well. They are not murderers, rapists, and drug dealers. They are people fleeing for their lives. These Latinos coming from Honduras, El Salvador, and Mexico. They are literally fleeing for their lives. Some of the women have seen their husbands killed in front of them, their daughters threatened with rape. They are literally fleeing for their lives, and to call them infestations is absolutely grotesque.
He is supported, of course, by his allies in the press. So let's look at a few of those examples, some of the commentary this week on Fox News.
Like it or not, these aren't our kids. Show him compassion. But it's not like he's doing this to the people of Idaho or Texas. These are people from another country.
And temporarily housed in what are essentially summer camps.
And I spoke to some African Americans who say, gosh, the conditions of the detention center are better than some of the projects that I grew up in.
Say one other thing, these child actors weeping and crying on all the other networks 24/7 right now, do not fall for it, Mr. President.
Because the people crossing that border, as the president has made clear throughout, are not coming across on the basis of merit.
If Lou Dobbs or Ann Coulter or Laura Ingraham are watching this, George, what do you want them to know?
They are so disassociated from reality. For Ann Coulter's to call the wailing and sobbing of those babies actors, it's grotesque. It is absolutely inhumane to hear that kind of talk. And it is that, just by repetition, time and again, that people take to be the reality. It is a big lie.
George, thank you for being here. Great to see you.
Pleasure.